I should be able to just... Oh my god, I'm so close! Wait, can you actually just climb up like this? I think you can. You can! You totally can just climb. Pro tip, alright? Totally knew that before. Awesome, super tip. Just do that. Just do that. It works really well. Hello, and welcome back to more Jak and Daxter. On the previous episode, we defeated a boss, we made it to a new area, and we found out what had happened to the Red Sage. So, now we need to fight... Well, okay, see, I was trying to, like, explain it without giving away all the story. So, pretty much, the Dark Eco Sage has been doing some bad stuff, and we need to go fight him. So, we're going to go fight him. Eventually, we need 72 power cells, which we actually do have 72 power cells right now. But I want to get them all before we beat the boss fight, because there's, like, a secret ending. It's not really a secret. You get an extra scene at the ending if you end up getting all 100 of the power cells, which I actually had forgotten about. I just wanted to get them all to get them all. But since there's actually like a reason to do it, I'm totally going to go ahead and do that. Now, we are going to speak with these fine gentlemen first before we set off on any adventures.
Hey, Gordy, I think we got visitors.
You think, Willard? Howdy, strangers. Passing through. Us too. Well, we gotta be moving on. Nothing to see here.
Duh, I thought you said this was a priceless gem worth...
Willard!
Actually, we want power cells, not gems.
We got 4 of them. Duh, you want them?
What Birdbrain here is trying to say is, we may have a few power cells laying around, and we might be willing to part with them for 90 orbs each.
Where have I heard that before? Hey, how do you two geniuses expect to get that big gem out of here anyway?
Well, smarty pants, we got 12 more years of digging to figure that out.
Gordy, wouldn't it take less time if you dug too?
I'll trade 90.
Oh, all right already. Here's a power cell for those orbs of yours.
Are all of them from them actually, like, just trading? Because I do not have enough precursor orbs to be able to trade straight up for power cells. I just traded them for 120 each to that magic man down there, the little statue. Where the hell is he? He's right in there. You can't really see him. He's on the left. You know what I'm talking about. The, like, vending machines almost. So, what I'm going to go ahead and do is I know where we're going to go next. We're going to go here to a nice little summit. This takes us up, very high up, to a nice little, a different place, a better place, a colder place. Takes us to the snowy mountain. It's a pretty cool, that was definitely pun intended. You'll see it, okay? I'm trying to think of the name of the place. I don't remember the name of the place, but I'll totally tell you once we get up there. Could I get out? Snowy Mountain! Hey, what do you know? This is Snowy Mountain. Hello, welcome to Snowy Mountain. Oh, fuck, dude! A giant, like, snow ape just attacked me. Or these are, like, you know, mobs. Okay. If they're infinite, I'm not messing with them. I think you actually have... Wait, what the hell? I got one of them? I did! Okay, so you can jump over these. For some reason, I was thinking that there was some machine you had to mess with. Okay, no more orbs up top. Damn, dude! Are these guys literally infinite? Because if so, I'm just not gonna mess with them. Alright, so you can actually go down here because the game is assuming, hey, you may fall. Also, they hid stuff down here. So the game's assuming, hey, you may not fall. You may be really good at the game. And then have to backtrack later whenever you're like, oh, dude, where'd my collectibles go? Like I would have had to done. But I knew it was there. So, you know, all is good, all is well. Okay. So this has giant rocks. I think you actually slide the other way. What the hell is this guy doing? Oh, maybe you don't. For some reason, I thought you went down the mountain. And that this stuff was like counterintuitive of me to go this way. But no, we're doing fine, it looks like anyway. What the hell is this? Dude, can I shoot magic energy balls? No, I think it just makes you punch harder. Yeah, I don't like this quite as much as the awesome energy balls, but I mean, it's all right, I guess. Wow, it looks cool. Look at that. Yeah, it looks awesome. Oh, I may have to have it for this. What the hell hit me? Are there spikes on that wheel? Is that what got me? Like, honestly, what? If that's what it was, I'll laugh a little. That'd be pretty funny. And then I'll cry a lot because it was stupid. Let's go ahead and make our way back up. So pretty much the objective of this level is, I don't know, travel through the snow, really. I mean, there's not like one single place we're trying to go to, whereas on some of the other ones there is. Some of them, not all of them, certainly not all of them. All right, well, that was my bad. That was definitely I screwed up kind of thing. You know, I don't actually know that, like, once I get in here, there's not really a reason for me to, once I get in here, there's really not a reason for me to turn the thing off, is there? I don't think there is. Like, it's not messing with me if it's on. Okay, so we're gonna take out this catapult, or weird machine thing. Oh, it's not like a catapult. Ow! Okay, so that's what hit me. So how do I beat this guy up? Oh, he just gets out sometimes. What the hell? I'm pretty sure I've completely forgotten how to play this game. Let's go ahead and take a little jump. Or maybe these new mob types are just... I don't know what's going on. Like, why it's so difficult. Like, okay, so I thought I could charge through that guy's attack. Obviously, I can't. One of the hits was a free hit. One of the times I got hit and I didn't need to. Okay, so this, you have to avoid. You have to dodge. Break a shield. There you go. Learning. That's how you learn. Very good. Whenever something screws up, you go, oh no, I'm gonna fix it. And then you fix it. It's pretty cool, man. So is there nothing I can do with this machine? I don't think there is, actually. I'm not sure. We'll leave it for now. There is another path that we can go on the left wall. And if we doubled back even more on the right, there would be another path, but we're saving that. Oh, but we are saving that. Did I die? Okay, apparently you could fall there. Man, I feel like I'm playing so poorly right now. Honestly, it's pretty demotivating. It really is. Like, I don't want to play if I'm playing like ass. Like, part of me playing is I want to teach people. I want to be like, hey, I know how to do this thing. Now you can know too. And with this, I'm fucking up. I'm fucking up a lot. There's a lot of screw ups. And it really sucks. Okay, so right here, we're gonna take our time. We're going to look down and see how we could ever go about getting down there. So, if you do look down, if we hug the right wall and then jump this way, we should be able to make it. Now, this, I don't think, is the normal way to get over here. If you wanna look at the normal way to get over here, you can do this. See, I guess maybe I'm just trying to do too many, like, fancy tricks. I'm trying to do too many loopholes, too many ways that aren't normal. So, if you wanted to go about going this way, we were literally just right there, then you take a right, you go around the side. This, I'm actually, you get a flut-flut here, so I'm not going to mess with that for now. We will mess around with a flut-flut later on, you know, get to ride them, jump around, lots of fun flut-flut stuff, you know, can't have just a super awesome character get out of the game. You gotta have flut-fluts, so... Not really. You could do without flut-fluts. Now this is ice. You slide and slip, and lots of danger is around the ice. So you got to be very careful there. I think if we jump this way, we have to be very careful to not fall because I want to sketch out the path real quick. I think there's a monster right there. Yep, little mob. Excuse me. Excuse me. I really hope they don't respawn. I don't think they do. I don't know what was up in the first area. Why they kept coming. Because I'm pretty sure that is not normal for them to continue going. Maybe there's just so many of them that I didn't realize that they weren't continuing to spawn. Not really sure. Okay, so let's go this way. Again, need to be really careful not to jump to our death. More of these. Okay, these guys pounding in the ice. Quit doing that. Quit pounding in the ice. Alright, and then you can interrupt his cast and take him out. Now, yeah, I don't really think that there's much we can do with that. Now this is going to be the hard part, getting back up. Oh, no, never mind. Oops. This is pretty damn easy, dude. I thought it was going to be a lot more difficult than that. And then we should be able to jump up. Ooh, actually, I don't think we can. Okay, cool. We can make it. All right. So now we can just take everything out in like one hit. And then there is a way we can go up to the left or to the right. Actually, the right takes you up, or you can keep going left and there is another path. Too many enemies, dude. I'm not wanting to stay here for too long. Yeah, see, look. Okay, now they're spawning. Now they are definitely spawning. What the hell? I couldn't hit him until he like saw me. I mean, I guess we gotta be fair, you know. Okay, so let's actually like just trap. I hate this game. Why is this happening? Like, what the hell, dude? All right, so we're gonna slide down and hopefully grab most of these. Okay, so we missed, like, all of them, just about. But hopefully we can get a nice jump. You know. Man, never lucky. I don't even know what to say. What the hell? What keeps happening? Why am I fucking up so much? All right, so this should be pretty easy to get now. I mean, I should be able to just... Oh my god, I'm so close! Wait, can you actually just climb up like this? I think you can. You can! You totally can just climb. Alright, pro tip. Pro tip, alright? Totally knew that before. Awesome, super tip. Just do that. Just do that. It works really well. As you can see, there's a little ice floor, so you can kind of see through it. It's not that thick. And there are plenty of stuff that we want to collect. So I have to pick that up real quick. Now, see these right here, I can understand why you'd want to deactivate these just because they kind of mess with you. But a lot of these don't even have like any goodies on them or anything. So I can also see why you just not touch them at all. All right, so let's keep moving this way. I'm not gonna fight all the monsters because that's not something I'm interested in. Oh, I think this can maybe be opened with the red stuff. I'm gonna try it out. I'm gonna see. Alright. So we need to hurry up and get to the red stuff, the red eco. I mean, we are in the area of the red sage. Excuse me. I don't know why I couldn't think of that. So nope. Not at all. Don't you worry. Red eco does nothing. Cool. All your dreams are a lie. Yeah, seriously, we can't break it. So there has to be some other way that you can break it. Wow, it does a lot of area of effect damage. I just fell to my death. And hopefully we didn't start too far away. No, we actually didn't. Okay, cool. Bye-bye, buddy. I'm going to leave you. Leave you be. You do whatever. Why does he keep jumping at me? I don't even want to fight. I mean, I don't want to fight any of them, to be fair. But, you know, the little cute one. No one wants to fight that. Stop popping so much. Is this guy like... Oh, I was about to say, is he not fight until... Okay, so you take damage. Oh, alright, you have to have the red eco, pretty much, to fight that guy. And you know what? That's okay with me, man. I'll go pick it up. Don't you worry, buddy. Hey, I'm gonna beat you up. Ew! So that's why you clear them all. You get a nice little power cell from them. And boom, 73, I believe, is the number that we're at now. Actually, 74. 74. We should be at 74. 74. Yeah, because I forgot we bought one from those people as well. Or I donated money to them and then they gave me something. Also known as buying. We traded. Alright, so let's crack this open. Come on. Why am I not jumping? Alright. Crack this bad boy open and then see if we can't fall down here. And by fall, I mean... not that! That's not what I meant by fall. I really didn't want to do that. Okay, you know, I think I may actually go down this way. Not yet. We're gonna take our time. So I don't want to go down that way. Well, I'm gonna explore the area to the right as well. This is an area I'm not super familiar with. We are getting close to the end of the game, so we are gonna be encountering things that I'm no expert on. I'm pretty sure you need a flat for there. But I don't see a spot for a flat, so I'm kind of blanking. I'm not really 100% sure what we're supposed to be doing there. Okay, so this area, I tried going down there. Did I try crossing the bridge though? Because I do see a light, so I think maybe this is where the flat is. Hey, what do you know, flat? See, I told you there was a flat. You didn't believe me, did you? You're like, no, Mason's crazy. But you know what? Yeah, I am a little, probably. But, shut up. Enough about that. I'm flooding. Alright, so this all has timed platforms that you have to get through. As you probably can tell already. So, let's get through the timed platforms, shall we? I can't believe I screwed that up. That really sucks. Okay, so the worst thing about this is it's sequential. You know, you gotta go in order. So, if you screw up once on some of this, you know, you make a risky jump, you're probably going to be not very happy. Alright, I think I can make that without hovering, but I'm gonna just hover just to be sure on that. Can you move a little more, platforms? You're freaking me out, dude. Go move. Thank you. Okay, actually, I think we're almost done with it. I think this is almost all the flood area, so it's not as bad as I thought it was. Cause I actually do think that we're getting towards the end of this. I don't think there are too many more. There could be a few more. No, I see a power cell right there. Of course I'm going to die right there whenever I'm talking about it, because I'm like, oh yeah, no, dude, it's actually really easy. I can't believe I had any trouble with this or thought that it was horrible, and then I like instantly screw up. You know, I figured the recording curse would have happened before, and it's just now happening, which I'm not sure if that's good or bad, because I got to show off in the first 8. But in 9 and 10, I'm kind of like, oh, I don't know what I'm doing. Yeah, see, like, look at that. If I waited half a second, I would have had the height to be able to just make it through there. But I didn't. I didn't wait the second. Or half a second. Whatever, dude. I didn't wait. And so I died. So next time, I'm going to wait. I'm going to let it line up. Because these timers really aren't anything to worry about. You can take your time. Pretty, I want to say, like, a huge amount of time, but you can wait a pretty decent amount of time. All right, let's go ahead and make this and see. Like, I'm gonna wait right here. I'm not fucking this up. Okay, you hear me, platforms? Huh? Do I intimidate you when I yell at you? I hope I do. I hope you cry, platforms. I hate you. These you can actually get in one jump. But these, I'm going to use the two, but kind of like coast at the end of it because I really don't want to screw up. Because we are right here, and boom, what do you know? Flut, excuse me, I have a prize to collect. That happens to be a nice little power cell, okay? I wanna get this power cell. Also, there's some sort of machinery we opened. Oh, cool, so once you get under this, it opens up the fort, which I'm glad I didn't explore, because now we can actually go to the fort. We close the door. We are at 75 power cells, okay? We need 100, so we are kind of far away, but at the same time, the levels are, there's not a lot of levels. I fucked up. Unless you can't get on the flip-flop. Can you not get on the flip-flop? Wait! Does that just take you to the top? Oh, sick, dude. Okay, cool. I figured we'd have to, like, jump all the way back up. No, it doesn't seem like that. So this just straight up takes me to the top. What's over here, though? That's what I want to know. What is down here? Oh god, that was scary. Alright, so we already destroyed all of this. We don't have to worry about that. Okay, I think I know where we are now. I'm actually gonna drop down and try and land on the platform. Okay, it took me back to where I wanted to go anyway. So right here is where we kind of branched off a little bit. Oh god. No spikes, please. No spikes. Ooh! Now we can hit him. Okay, so this thing has got to go. Or I can just punch my way through everything. Yeah, you know, things okay, I guess. I can just punch my way around. And that's pretty much dead end. So we are gonna be wanting to make our way to the fort. There's still some side stuff that we can do, but I think the majority of the action going on is going to be over here. The snow is really cool, but it's also kind of annoying falling through it. Like, it's really annoying how deep some of it is. I really wish I didn't have to worry about that as much. I think there's actually a glitch to where you can get up here. Or it very well may not be a glitch. You can get up here. There's some... I do recall there is a glitch to skip through part of the level. Though, I just have to, you know, actually remember where it's at. Alright, so that did something. What did that do? Dude, I have no idea. Actually, no, I think I did skip through part of the level. I don't think I'm supposed to be able to do that. I'm not gonna make that. I did the circle way off-timed. And you may be thinking, wow, no, dude, you did the circle perfect. You just jumped after it. Well, shut up. I thought I screwed up. I predicted that I screwed up by screwing up after I screwed up. There we go. All right, cool. So you can grab onto that. I think we may actually be able to do the same for this. Yeah. I think we could just, like, go through the whole level like that. There's a lot of spots on this game where I'm like, I don't think they did the spin jump. Pretty sure they didn't do the spin jump here. They did not test this with this magic jump. That is not a way we can go, but this maybe. I'm gonna try it. Ah, dude, we made it! I did not think I was gonna be able to land that. Well, since we went ahead and were able to do that, I'll double back just to make sure I grab everything. I'm not actually sure how you're supposed to get up here, but I do know that spin jump is pretty good. All right, so this is pretty much taking me to the area that I was going to show off a minute ago, and then I fell and yelled. I screamed a little bit, but you know what? That's okay. So that right there are some very nice precursor orbs, you see, and I actually am quite the collector, so I'm going to collect them. Whoa, that's what collector means? You collect things? Yeah, I know, pretty crazy, right? I wouldn't be surprised if your brain just exploded right now. All right, so let's jump up here, grab that. Now what I want to do is do a little bit of scouting. Okay, I want to figure out how exactly are we going to get over there without doing the level legit. Because screw that, dude. Why would we play legit? We gotta find all the sick shortcuts. I think there's actually like something that opens up to get you up there. That gets you up there, not to get you up there. I do kind of want to jump off of this right here and see what happens. Yeah, okay, that was fine that I did that. Whoa, that was maybe not fine that I did that though. That was fine that I did that. God, the spin things are so weird because, like, I don't know. There's so many different ways to go about doing the spinning, and you can hit different buttons to do it different ways. So there's too many variables, really. There's way too many variables because you can, like, end it quicker if you hit circle as opposed to, like, hitting X to jump because that's the jump button. I'm going to wait a second. Because I was still talking. I know I'm not really talking, I'm just explaining, so that's like also rambling. We're gonna pick it up. Look at that beautiful smile. Okay, so 76 of these bad boys have been collected. Now, I actually think I could have jumped from there up to there, so I'm probably going to try and do that. Oh my god, I cannot believe this is... I should speedrun this game. I am, like, so lucky with all these grabs and jumps. So I'm going to wait up here real quick for that for the eco to respawn, and then I'm going to jump down to the ground because there's stuff I can open with said eco. No, I'm not going to be able to open them all. Are you fucking serious, dude? I took fall damage, so I couldn't open the last one. Oh, man, I'm going to have to scale this thing up. Okay, so this is how you start it off. Like, it's pretty easy to do, as you can see, but being able to just, like, free jump is a lot easier, so. But yeah, no, it took no time at all. That's totally fine. All right, grab this. Now let's slowly go down. Did it open? No, I decided I wasn't going to slowly go down, which I guess was my bad. I should have slowly gone down. But I waited too long, and I didn't want to have to wait for the eco to respawn. I tried doing some flashy tricks right there. It didn't work. It didn't work at all. So let's just hug this real quick, and we'll take out an enemy and get it. There we go. See, much easier if you just break it down into two steps instead of one. There's not really a need to do the one step. I mean, the two steps still pretty damn easy. And if we can pick up some of this health, that would be fantastic. Or we could just get full health by dying. Anyway, that's probably going to wrap it up for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Now, we still need to get one scout fly on the next video. We need to continue exploring Snowy Mountain. We need to deactivate the precursor blockers. There's a lot of stuff that's going to go on the next video. We were only able to pick up three of these, but we did get a decent amount of the precursor orbs, okay? Only 3 power cells from the Snowy Mountain, but again, we got a ton of precursor orbs. Like, we can get 2 more power cells just because we did that. And then we need to get 90 more, which there's a whole other area, so we'll do pretty good on that. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to see any other game videos or tech or anything, there's a lot of videos on my channel. If you want to browse the channel, see if you find something you like, and then subscribe, that would be fantastic. If not, oh well, that's okay. Still more Jak and Daxter for you. Until the next video, thank you so much for watching. Take care. Goodbye.